Well, here we go again. Another attack on free speech. And this time it's coming from our neighbors up north. Surprise, surprise. They don't even have the First Amendment up there. Okay. Remember this classic album? This is Brothers in Arms by Dire Straits. This album came out in 1985 and it featured one of the biggest hits of all time. Money for Nothing. That's right. Money for Nothing. Now, if you listen to this song on most radio stations, they don't play the second verse of Money for Nothing. Why? Because in the second verse of Money for Nothing, the word faggot is mentioned 3 times. Now, this has always been, this verse has always been cut from most radio stations. They added the verse out. But this album right here, Brothers in Arms, it has the full version of the song with the second verse included. Now, let's see what these assholes are called. Okay, the C.B.S.C., the Canadian Broadcast Standards Council. Sounds like a bureaucracy to me. The Canadian Broadcast Standards Council is making a big fuss about the word faggot being used in that song because people call into the radio stations and say they're offended by the use of the word faggot in the song, the second verse of Money for Nothing. Well, did you ever hear of turning off the radio? You don't want to hear it. You don't want to hear the word faggot mentioned in the song. All you have to do is turn off the fucking radio. It's as simple as that. But no, the Canadian Broadcast Standards Council is demanding that word be banned from the song. They don't want radio stations to play the full version of the song. They say that doesn't fit their standards. That word is unacceptable. Well, isn't that what the First Amendment's all about? Canadians don't have that. So, radio stations are going to have to add it, the version, the second verse of this song, right out of their, they won't play it. They'll have to cut it off. Now, that pisses me off because I'm a big proponent of free speech. So, again, one more time, I have to take a stand for free speech. So, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to sing to you that controversial second verse of the song Money for Nothing. So I'm going to have to do my very best Mark Knopfler impersonation. Now, let's see how this is going to go. Umba, umba. Hey, I feel like Mark Knopfler already. Let's see how this is going to go. Look at that, look at that. My Mark Knopfler, bitch. Gonna get my guitar in the MTV. Oh, it's not easy being Mark Knopfler. How do people talk with that voice anyway? I don't know, it's beyond me. If I had to talk like that all the time, I would lose my voice. Gotta get my guitar. Oh, it's not easy being Mark Knopfler. Let's move Mr. Microphone over here so we can capture my glorious voice. Alright. My guitar. Mr. Microphone, get over here. Yes, sir. Let me see. How does this work? Oh! Mark Knopfler's having problems with his guitar. Something like this. Alright. Alright. You ready? Okay. Umba umba. Oh, it's not easy being me.
Perhaps I should have brought a bottle of water over here. My throat's damn dry over here, but we're going to try to do this anyway.
That little faggot got the earring and the makeup. Yeah, buddy, that's his own hair. That little faggot got his own jet airplane. That little faggot is a billionaire.
Ooh. Hey. Oh, boy.
I can't be Mark Knopfler for too long here, folks, but you get the idea.
Every time I play that song by Dire Straits, I'm going to play the full version of Money for Nothing and the Chicks for Free. Because you can't ban free speech. You can't ban the word faggot from the song just because you don't like it. People are too fucking sensitive these days. Too fucking sensitive. Fuck political correctness.
I'm gonna sing that little faggot every day.
Stand up for free speech, folks. Even if it means losing your damn voice. Stand up for free speech. Canada, ban free speech. Q, you're out of here.